So, new leaked photos reveal the extent to which U.S. border facilities are being overwhelmed by the inflow of migrants from Central America and other nations. And the news site Breitbart exclusively obtained the photos that are reminiscent of the Obama-era border surge. The images depict a Border and Customs Protection Processing Detention Center and transport facility at a U.S. port of entry in El Paso, Texas. According to the source of the images, the photos were taken on February 17th, 2019. The images were provided by a source obtaining under the umbrella of the Customs Border Protection, who spoke with Breitbart on the condition of anonymity and stated, "The medical staff at their facility can't keep doing this. They are getting overwhelmed." Another source operating under the umbrella of Customs and Border Protection spoke with Breitbart under the same condition and stated, quote, "This is no different than what we were dealing with during the Obama administration. This is happening in the Rio Grande Valley sector, the Del Rio sector, and the El Paso sector, the Tucson sector, the Yuma sector, and the San Diego sector. It's almost across the entire southwest border that we are being overwhelmed by migrant families." The source added, "We are basically facilitating Mexican cartels' migrant smuggling operations into the interior of America. We are babysitting and not securing our border. The flow shows no signs of abating and it keeps increasing." And if you guys want to go ahead and check out that full article, the link to that will be in the description box below. And if you guys saw the images that we, was posted and I had on screen for a while there, it is clear and cut as day that this migrant situation is out of hand. And this is something that truly upset me. I saw, quote unquote, conservatives in my own comment section bashing Trump and his decision to make the national emergency in order to get the funds in order to build the wall. I saw these, quote, conservatives bashing him and saying that he's messing up the Constitution by doing this. And for the last and final time, President Trump has the executive power to do the national emergency if he believes our national security as a nation is under threat. And by the photos you saw that were leaked by a Border Protection's agent, it is clear as day that we are being overwhelmed by this inflow of illegal migrants. And as you saw in the photos, these illegal immigrants were packed into these, tiny little holding cells like sardines. They were packed in there so, compressly that they were sleeping on the floor, that they were laying on the floor. And that is no fault on we the conservatives, President Donald Trump, nor is it fault for the Immigration and Border Protection agents who house and detain these people once they come into America. And if all these liberals and all these, fake conservatives talking crap about President Trump and so forth, they can just take these immigrants and take them to their houses. Nancy Pelosi can easily fit all of these people in her big mansion. Without a shadow of a doubt, they can do this, but they don't because they're hypocrites. And again, Trump has the full executive power to install this national emergency in order to allocate funds to fix this problem. And this problem was brought on by both Republicans and Democrats who formed that dumb bill that essentially gave a huge incentive for these illegal immigrants to not only migrate here, but smuggle in their kids, smuggle and use children as a form of like a pawn, like a ticket to get into the United States. And while they are there at these detention centers, again, packed in like sardines, the Border Patrol agents cannot DNA test these children to make sure that these kids that these immigrants bring with them are actually their blood children. Not, relatives like their nieces or nephews or friends' kids, because more or less, that is the case in a lot of these illegal immigrants. They end up buying kids, like literally an auction is going on, and you can buy a kid and then you can use that kid to successfully get into the United States. And the kid most likely doesn't speak any English, so when they are questioned by border securities, they don't know what they're talking about. And the worst part of all is that President Trump and his, border wall and construction isn't going to begin for another few months, which means that this kind of situation, these poor border security agents are going to have to deal with this up until the construction of the border wall is undergoing. Because just like in my last video, Trump is going to face mass resistance from everybody and their mother. He's going to face resistance from his own party, the Republicans, the fake conservatives. He's going to face resistance from liberal states, California, obviously, the Democrats, the courts. He's going to face resistance from his own supporters, in a sense. President Trump has a truly uphill battle when it comes to illegal immigrants and funding his border wall. And you could hear liberals right now, you know, saying, look at these photos. Is this any way humanitarian? And I would say, no, it's not humanitarian. But you are the party who incentivizes these people to come here on false hopes. You are the party that incentivizes these people to come here, all based on lies, just so you can use them as a loyal voting base, because you know that all your other loyal voting bases are diminishing, are going to the Green Party, are hopping on the Trump train. The Democrats in office should be absolutely ashamed of themselves, because they are the cause of this. They are the reason this is happening. And these illegal immigrants are not dumb. They are not stupid. They fully understand what's going on here in America, and they are trying to take full advantage of it. You know, go back in the beginning of the video and look at the photos. Pause it and look at those photos and see how many kids you see in those photos. There is a reason for that. Because with the new bill that both Democrats and Republicans signed, gives great initiative to these illegal immigrants to use these kids as pawns. And you know, it is really damaging, because look at it through this lens. Let's say, you know, maybe 30% of these illegal immigrants, at least now, you know, these kids are actually their children. They want to come here to, you know, they come here on false hopes. They come here because they want to give a better life for their kids. I can understand that. As a parent, you want what's best for your child, and I can 100% get behind that. But here is the issue. Now, since you have all these other illegal immigrants, I would say upwards to like 70% of illegal immigrants are now going to be abusing this system that says that if you bring a kid with you across the border, then you are automatically guaranteed safe passage through the United States and granted to go into the interior of the country because you have that kid with you. And that essentially opens the door to the abuse of the system. And that means that if you are an illegal immigrant who actually has legitimate concerns and want to come here for the best of your child, you will be watered down. Your proposal, your wants will be watered down because every single other illegal immigrant is saying the exact same thing. And it devalues, you know, your argument when it comes to, I want to do it for the best of my child. So, you know, this whole illegal immigrant thing, it's bad for everybody. It's bad for we the people, the American citizens. It is bad for the legal immigrants who come here the right way, go through the legal process and so forth. It's bad for them because these illegal immigrants are going to force politicians to make stricter and stricter immigrant policies, which makes future immigrants who want to come here, it's going to make it harder for them because of these mass inflow of illegal immigrants. It doesn't benefit the illegal immigrants because then, you know, us American citizens are going to have a bad view of them. They're basically being used as pawns, and they have to work extra harder in order to make a living here because, you know, they're undocumented. So that leaves the politicians and the people, you know, who run these big corporations who want to seek out and hire these people. They are the only people who benefit from this. These illegal immigrants being shipped here, literally in like these buses that are provided by the Mexican government, being shipped here in these buses, filled to capacity like sardines, and then being let out at the United States border. At the most weakest points of the border, again, I mind you. Again, if you guys want to read this article, the link to that will be in the description box below. But it goes to show you just how many people are against President Trump. How many people are giving him resistance in terms of the national emergency and border funding. When you even have conservatives, people are supposed to be on Trump's side of this, going against him and saying that he's in the wrong for doing this, for bypassing Congress and so forth. Again, you know, Trump has full executive power to do such a thing in regards to protecting our national interests. And stopping illegal immigrants, stopping this kind of stuff from happening, is most definitely in our national interests. And Trump, as the president of the United States, has to take into account what he must do in order to make sure that we're safe as Americans, even if a lot of people aren't going to like it. You have a lot of conservatives, you have a lot of Republicans out there who are fighting Trump on this because they don't see illegal immigration as a very pressing issue right now. Because right now, short term, we're doing fine. But Donald Trump is thinking about long term, that the long term effects of illegal immigration on our country. And long term effects are pretty negative and pretty bad. And that's what he's setting up to protect. And I totally agree with him doing such a thing. But that all being said, you guys go ahead and let me know what you thought about this in the comment section below. And that's it for this video. Peace out, guys.